I think we got audio today. We had some green lights whenever I talk. That's seeming promising. Yesterday I did a whole live stream where there's no chat and no voice. Oh my god, it worked! Sound dogs! Yes! Oh, what's up, buddy? How's Burning Man? Burning Man was freaking awesome. It's such a lot of work to get there. But once you're there, it's like, it's a creative reset button for me. I feel like afterwards, I'm just ready to go for a whole other year. I feel so inspired by other people's creativity and stuff. It's a radical place. How about yourself, man? How's your week? Last 2 weeks, man, it's been 2 weeks. This is so funny. Yesterday I did a live stream and the voice didn't work. I didn't even record my voice. And the chat didn't work. There's nobody on chat. Nobody is like this. I didn't even stream. And then today, I haven't changed a single damn thing. And everything's working fine. Go figure. I don't know why we're doing this. Pedro, what's up? High five, y'all. School started. Nice. It's going well. Right on. How did the last term turn out? Pedro! I know, right? The fail yesterday was funny as hell. And like I said, nothing has changed. Absolutely nothing has changed since yesterday. None of my settings. I literally just clicked play today and it works. Yesterday it didn't work. 4.0 for the past two semesters? Holy crap. Yeah, so this is the tower. That's why the music sounds really intense and stuff. Just creating the structure for it right now. So, like, this will be the top floor or whatever. Let's see what this will actually be. Yeah, this is the top floor. This is where that's where the final boss fight will happen. What's up, Scissor? Yo! My vacations were great. Yes, they were excellent. Just what I needed. Burning Man is this experience that, like, forces you to connect with other people. It forces you to be real. You know, it forces you to have a good time. Or else you just have a bad time. It forces you to have some kind of time. I always come back from Burning Man so inspired. Like, I spent this entire week reorganizing my closet where I got my whole computer set up here. I hung my guitars on the wall. I don't know if you can see that from here. But I'll do, like, some kind of panorama photo of this whole creative space. Because it's, like, way more... I don't know, it's just, I got so inspired by people's creativity. I came home and was like, I want to do this, I want to do that. I was just manning out. I went and reorganized the entire, like, downstairs closet area so we could have an easier next Burning Man. It's weird to see what other people's creativity will do to you and your own creativity. So, Arcane, what's up, man? What's up? I'm so happy the chat's working today. It's so funny. Jonah! What's up? What's up? What's up, y'all? How have y'all been? Saladong's got 4.0 for the past two semesters. That's freaking awesome. Alright, so I got the structure for the tower going. This is, the tower is a bunch of levels where every single level has a boss on it, or a mini boss. And, now I'm just working on the connectors between them, so there'll be little elevators going between each level. So, let's see, this is what it kind of looks like overall from a map perspective. Yeah, in Portugal? Oh yeah, super crowded, super small, uh-huh. Yeah, Burning Man is very open. I mean, there's so much room at Burning Man. You have plenty of room to dance everywhere you go. And it could still have thousands and thousands of people at just one little dance event. Because there's like, at Burning Man, there's like a bajillion different events going on all the time. So that you can find anything just about any hour. Your semester's starting and you don't want it to? Oh! Yeah, there's lots of space. There's so much space. That's really nice. It's a really nice thing about Burning Man. So I know what you mean. Like, you go to the club in your town and you want to go and dance or whatever. You can't dance in a lot of clubs because there's just not that much room. You can't get wild. You can't spin on your head and, like, break yourself trying to do break dancing. But out there you can. So what I'm working on here game dev-wise is this. This is the first level of the tower is Z9 right here. So this is level 1 of the tower. And it's just this little square like this the whole time. And then these levels are, you go up the tower, you go to this one, and then this one, and this one, and this one, and this one. And this is the final level where you fight the final boss here. Every single level has a boss or a mini boss, so it's kind of like a boss grind. Scissor, it says on the Kickstarter the estimated delivery date was December 2015. Any reasons for the delay? Yes, there's many reasons for the delay. On Kickstarter, you can put your estimated delivery date or whatever, and then you can never, ever change it afterwards. So, yes, at that time, when I did the Kickstarter in March or April of 2015, December 2015, at that point, was the minimum, right? I was like, okay, if I get the $9,000 I'm asking for on this Kickstarter, I'll be able to make this game until December 2015. I thought I made that pretty clear on the Kickstarter page, but you'd have to like read the whole page to understand that, right? So yes, it says December 2015 because that was the minimum, right? But since the game got funded past what it was supposed to, so I got more time. So that means that I had another at least 6 months I could do to develop it. And then since then, I've been alpha funding it, so people have been buying into the beta and stuff like that. So I'm able to make this game better and better and better because more and more funds have come in. So that's why you can't change your date. You can't change anything about your Kickstarter page after your Kickstarter's over. So I hope that makes sense. And yes, there will be more delays. I don't know exactly how long it will be till Songbringer's out, but when it is out, it will be awesome. I'll have spent so much time making it awesome that I promise you it will be awesome. Jonah, you played it? Nice. Lots of surprises. Yeah, cool. You found lots of... Nice. You like the Songbringer dungeon? That's cool. I like it too. I like that it's really sparse and weird and all these super crazy tunnels. We all missed your birthday, Pedro. Don't feel pressure. Right on, man. Pedro, how's the new job, man? Azarus, what's up? What's up, Azarus? I've been at Burning Man. This was my vacation for the year. I went to Burning Man, and it totally refreshed me. It was exactly what I needed vacation-wise. Came back inspired as hell. It's like creativity puking everywhere. Creativity, puke, puke, blah, blah. Creativity. Still more creativity to put into this room. It's nice to add creativity to your workspace, you know, and then it kind of like inspires you all year. So one of the first tasks I want to do today, game dev wise, is to take it so... The second level, the second floor of this tower links together to the first level's elevator. So this first floor, whatever, will have an elevator here. And then you go one room to the right, you go one room up, you fight a boss, and then it activates its elevator here. So on the next floor, the elevator will be here and the boss will be down here or there. Depends. So each level of the tower will have its elevator connected to the same spot on the floor previous. So that's my first task of the day. So how to do that? I guess I need to start with each one of these levels of the tower can have a different starting point. That's what's got to happen first, man. That's going to be in world. World CPP, well, it's going to be in, like, create Z, maybe. Maybe. Maybe not. Maybe do, maybe don't. It's going to be this. Extra dungeon floors, create dungeon Z. You have bad news? They offer you the position. You said you needed a week to decide. 1 week after I accepted, they said they were glad and they would contact me again. 1 week after, they called me saying they got another person for the job. What? Liars. Why did you lie to Pedro? This is not good, Pedro. Damn, I'm sorry, man. Sorry to hear that. What about the other ones? You got, don't you got a couple other ones still? Each one of these extra dungeon floors, I don't think it actually uses a start X, start Y. No, it doesn't. Does not. Oh, okay, so that means it just create dungeon Z is where it'll generate. Totally, I agree with you, Arcane. It's totally normal to have a week to decide on a job. Yeah, their loss. Oh no, it all went to shit. All of it, all of it. Shape width, shape height. So dungeon generate just needs a starting point. Okay, so it's gonna be a dungeon where it generates and it, we can push back, shape reserved. Yeah, okay, so each level of the tower is just gonna have a different shape to reserve. Because the shape height and the shape width is 2x2. And I guess we could go 3x3 at some point too. 3x3 would change things a bit. But there's no such thing as like setting a start point. All the game dev related. Oh no. No, there's none left in a 200 mile radius. Oh man. What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do, man? What's your plan now? Oh, you started looking for IT consulting. Oh, there are lots of them. Okay. Okay, well that sounds like a start. Move to Spain. So I'm thinking what I'll do is I'll reserve a different shape. So if it's one floor, the first floor you start with the entrance down the bottom left. The next time, you'll start with, oh, but how would the shape work? Oh yeah, you just have to reserve a shape around the top. Okay, I think I'm gonna do a Z even, Z odd. Even floors have entrance to lower left. If Z mod 2 equals 0. This is kind of a simple way to do it. Hack it out. Hack it out. Just hack it. Get it going. Don't stare at the blank page for too long. Enko, what's up, Enko? Where have I been? I've been on vacation. I've vacated the premises for a bit. I was at Burning Man. I'm getting my creative energies recharged. Been so inspired. It's good to be back, though. It's very good to be back. I missed Songbringer. The first week, I really missed working on Songbringer. I was like, man, this sucks being on vacation. I just want to make Songbringer. But when I got into it, I was like, man, I'm so glad to be here at Burning Man now. We finally all set in and stuff. You'll probably be able to try again in 6 months. Well, there you go. Yeah, you could try again at these spots, right? It's so weird because you were almost about to get hired at like two of these places, you know? So I think you would have a good chance of getting hired again later on down the road. Uh-huh. Oh, yeah, and that would also give you a chance to get some experience under your belt, too. So if I reserve to the right and reserve above, so I width, this is going to be not zero, but oh yeah, X is I, Y is 1. Let's try that. Okay, so this is odd floors have entrance to upper right. Let's hope that works. Make some game dev in your free time. Keep developing your skills. Have something to show. Totally, like your one game a month jams. So you're available for Songbringer too. Nice. Right on. Okay, so yeah, it looks like this is crashing it. Either that or it's just like, I think it's just getting, yeah, no possible parent rooms for room 4. Because I've reserved there and there, and it allowed a move there. So we want to go one more move to the left when we're reserving those even shapes or odd shapes. One, this is shape width, this is I equals -1. So today I'm working on the structure for the tower. This is the last level of the game. On each level of the tower, you have to fight a boss, like either a mini boss or an existing boss again. I'm not sure how much I want to reuse bosses because bosses are so fun. Bosses are so fun to create. Ah, so we're going for the third room, and it's failing each time. It's like, doop, doop, oops, oop, doop, oops, oops, doop, oops, oops, oops. I just can't do it. The third room is the before boss. Well, it's because it keeps on going to the left. Always to the left. It's like, yep, left, 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 left. Oh, did I reserve? Oh. Okay, this is why. The boss room. It's reserved there, but this boss room is going to be reserved. Oh, wait. The boss room will have to be in the lower. Or in the upper. Boss rooms always have to have something else below it to the south, so you can always enter from the south and see the boss in its full glory and all that. So that means the boss room either has to be in the top right or the top left. Which is really going to mess things up. So you would go first floor, you would start, say, bottom left, doesn't matter, and you walk to the top right. The next floor, you go top right, back to top left, and then top left to top right to top left. I guess that would work. I guess it would be better than just to have each floor on the even floors. We have the top left one. Okay, let's try that. Just watch out for sneaky clauses. Uh-huh. Yeah. Oh, wow. Even if it's stuff you do at home or not at work. Yeah, that's something to watch out for sure. What's up, High Gates? Hello, High Gates. What's up? Welcome. I'm glad you're inspired and motivated. It's so good to be inspired and motivated, isn't it? Okay, so I'm going to take this odd floor here and make it so it's... No, wait. Even rooms. Hell, the even... Well, let's keep this even floor like that for a moment. And then we still have the boss room to add... Well... -1? Looks like this is failing too. Damn. I thought by reserving... See, it's still putting a room to the left. Why does it only go to the left there? It does not like this whole plan, changing the entrance point. Meh. I think I'm gonna have to pause and think about this and do it a different way later on. Isn't working right now, and I got some other ideas in the back of my mind somewhere back there. I know I've got some ideas about how to place the entrance point for a dungeon in a different place, so let's leave it how it was. Okay, so we're back how we were. This is the last floor of the dungeon. Or the last... Okay, let's get some light pillars in here. It's looking weird without those. Light pillar. Shadow, these are they have shadows. One light pillar. Call this the T light pillar. Are there several of them? I don't think there are. There's supposed to be only one, I think. So I'll render this one T light pillar 0. Okay, that'll give us light pillars. The next thing, I guess I'll make it so fighting bosses need to be a lot better. Because we're going to have like five different bosses on this in this one dungeon. And I want this to kind of be a grind. Like, you have to fight all five bosses in one save game. If you die, you have to go fight all of them again. This is kind of punishing, though. Well, I guess, wait a minute. We've got the data, saves, We could make it, yeah, I guess we could. It is possible to make this instead of having or marking a boss the night the last tower dungeon, marking the boss is defeated could mean that all of the bosses on the way up the tower are no longer there, but the last boss is always there. That would be good. And then you could fight all five bosses and leave the save point there. Or somehow save at the very top, or come back down the tower and save. Something like that. Okay, so basically this is I'm gonna code this so I can do either way. I can force the player to fight all the bosses on this dungeon in one save game, or I can add a save point at the top, either way, with the same code. Last playthrough you did, you had trouble with the Wall of Eyes boss. He's a tough one. He's a tough one. Did you have the gate item? Did you get the glove? Let's start back at the bottom of the tower. Start all the way at the all on the ground. Bell tries to attack the bombs. Okay, so it'll be a boss fight here. Let's see if we can use this elevator. Oh, you can use the elevator while the boss is there. Okay, that needs to be fixed. Let's put that player back there, 1185. So. Well, okay, so there's one way to beat that boss, and that's by pure button mashing. You just have to swing your sword as fast as you possibly can. But I'm sure there's got to be other ways to beat that boss, you know? There's got to be some other strategy there that works. And if there's no other way to beat that boss than just swinging your sword as fast as you can, I'm gonna find a way. I'll develop a way so that there's an alternate route to beating that boss, because as it stands, that's the only strategy I've found that works. But I want there to be at least two. Just so the game isn't so linear. I really hate linear games. I hate it when you're railroaded into one choice, when you're just corralled into making one decision only. I really hate video games like that. Newer Zeldas. Newer Zeldas. Sorry, I just have a cough. Right, yeah, there's lots of things left to do with that boss too. Like the little eyes are gonna have, attacks as well too. So that's kind of like everything you're seeing in Songbringer as far as the bosses go right now is this is a rough sketch. These are rough sketch bosses. There's gonna be a whole nother week put into each dungeon. And boss. Right. First of all, I don't want the player to be able to use the elevator until. Until they beat the boss, of course. I thought there was something that locked all doors. Which should be locking the. Where does it actually lock doors? Here it is. Yeah, okay, here's where it locks the doors, checks completion, activate area incomplete. We step into this lock doors method, door system. Oh, we want to go and not only lock doors, but lock any exit components as well. Isn't there an There is an exit system. Here's where we want to do lock exits. But that's going to set the filter to static. So if the exit component has a flux type, which is elevator, okay, so for locking the doors. Unlocking, we set back to K filter exit. If collision, no, we want the exit component as well. All right, so if exit dot flux type is okay, flux elevator up or make this cleaner. Is elevator? K filter none. K filter static. I wonder how this will work with other types of transitions. Right, lock exits. We want to lock the exits and activate area complete when we lock the doors. It has the K flag locked. We want to lock the doors. Or collision category, K filter none. So if there's no doors at all, we had to exit spikes. Actually, either way, we're locking the exits. There, that looks better. So that will basically, this will make it so we can have a boss and an exit component, or an elevator. Boss is already gone though. Where'd you go, boss? What's up, dude? Hey, the what? Hold on. Recommend you something. Have you played Momodora? It's not a $20 game, but Momodora Reverie Under the Moonlight's a pretty good one. I just played. I liked it a lot. Was it Momodora 4? Yeah. I like this one. Momodora Reverie Under the Moonlight. It's a Metroidvania. It's pretty good though. Highly recommend it. Check it out. You can fight this boss. You just fight her tits, basically. You're just like, bam, 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 bam. Fight the tits. I'll be right back. Gotta take a quick break. You play this one-handed? Wow. I got some messages. All right, so I changed some code And everything with this boss. And suddenly there's no boss. Could have been this. Could have been that. I definitely do have none of the bosses have been flagged as defeated yet. So there should be a boss right here. There's a let's play of a guy 100%ing Super Mario 64 with his feet? Oh my god, dude. Oh, I'm gonna watch that. That sounds so awesome. What? How did I break this? Cool. Baby, I'm streaming. That didn't fix it either. Oh, wait. Yeah, the room is different.
Yep.
There's guitars on the wall now. You can't really see it from this angle, but I've got my whole mastering set up now. So like I got my musical equipment all set up down here, so I can flip on a switch. Can't really hear that hum, but like I got some studio monitors down here so I can actually do some proper mastering of the audio for Songbringer. Yeah, I worked hard. It took a while. Super Mario 64 with feet! Sweet. What did I do to break this guy? I broke him, man. So if that's false and this is not there, this should be exactly as it was. Or not, no, wait a minute, no. It's not exactly as it was. Because the collision system, it required this in order to lock exits. Oh my god, it's the curious case of the missing boss. What happened? I've only been coding for like a half an hour and... This is what happens when you go on vacation. Nothing makes sense. It takes you 3 or 4 days just to get back in the groove of everything. Boss, okay, I know for a fact there's this boss is... It's not triggered to be gone. Where? What about his item? Ugh. What did I do? What did I do? Okay, that's exactly as that was. Okay. It's not this. What the hell? That's exactly as it was, basically. Okay, it's not that. Just put the collision system and the exit system all the way back to normal. Didn't fix it. This? Wah! Okay, I'm setting a breakpoint where it normally will erase an enemy if you've already defeated a certain area or whatever. Nothing. What the hell? What? Nothing. Oh my God. There's a boss here like 10 seconds ago. What happened in the meantime? Names, it says names, who knows, it might be empty, probably is empty. Yeah, it's just, there's no enemy here. What, in tarnation? I didn't change that much of code. What the hell's going on? Freaking bugs. Thank you. confused. All right, that was the second floor the entire time. Oh. Okay, apparently the second floor has no boss. All right, that's the problem. Okay. Oh. All right, so back, hopefully, yeah. There we go. Man, that was a long goose chase. All right, good. I cannot walk on this exit. If I kill the boss. Use the exit now. That's all I wanted from earlier. That's all I wanted. All right, I want to double check this. Start at 9. Seems to have worked. I want to make sure that this change does not break any other bosses, though. Say we'll go to 5, 6, 7. No? 5, 6, 7? Eh. Didn't change the world, did it? Zero retries. What happened to my world? What world is this? Xanadu? Purple, please. This is Xanadu. Right? Xanadu. Okay. I might have broken the world already. This is a different world. Now. I broke so far was the whole world. Okay, I gotta figure out why the world's broken. I guess I could check in what I already did. I think I see what's going on. When I went to that Verloc room, it locked the exits. So cool here. I can run around in God mode. It seems like I get to this room, though. No longer exit. No, unless... Oh, that's pretty good. That actually fixes the old bug where you could actually walk into... does fix a bug. Only problem is if I'm trying to run around in God mode, I'll get stuck on areas like that. That's okay. I think I'd like this better, actually, if it were checking if flux type was flux slide. flux slide can become K filter static. So slide becomes static. No, that's not right. Elevator is actually better because we would want both slide and downstairs and upstairs to both have static. Yeah. We got a smarter way to do this too. Collision dot category is not equal to collision dot original category. So if the category has been changed, an exit component has its category changed, the doors are locked. If it has its original category, it's all good. Make sure things still function the same. I think that's a little cleaner. Cleaner code. Won't break later. Okay, I can still use exits until I get here. And now exits don't work. Can't even walk on that anymore. That's good. Alright, cool. As soon as the enemies all die. The exit components work again. Let's go back to Dungeon 9. Wait, what happened to Dungeon 9? Okay, good. The elevator is not working. Good. That's a little cleaner. Okay, so elevator. So the exit components lock if the room is locked. And if the door, if there's no doors, then it does exit spikes. This is can't use elevator when fighting boss. Imperative. What's up, Gladiar? Why do we sell it? Okay. Why does it say two modified when there's nothing modified? Let's modify. Oh. Guess we need those. Okay. Oh, git commit messages are imperative? Oh. I guess some people will consider them imperative. Watch this. I'm gonna do a git commit. This is a totally imperative. But it, right? I did something. What up, Gladiar? What up? There we go. Okay, so I got a couple things fixed just there. Basically, you can't use an elevator if you're fighting a boss. Can't use the elevator right then. So that makes it so the tower has elevators in the same room as the boss room. Okay, so let's see. Do I got a little bit left in me today? A little bit left in me? What else would I do? Try and. Thanks, Gladiar. Thanks, Gladiar. You like that commit message? What was I gonna do next? Oh yeah, so if you've already defeated the boss, I don't want it to do this boss intro thing. This should be pretty quick. Oh, also, I need to check the entire world because I think I broke the entire world already. Let's go back a little bit. Tower floors, music, tower, dot, dot. Tower started. I think this is the one to get right here, this commit. So I should have no. Okay, cool. We can check out that branch. Actually, before I check out that branch, let's compare it against this. So here's our new. Here's. Let's get some old. All right, it's gonna have to probably recompile everything for this. That's okay. So I'm gonna get a basically a text file with the whole output of the old world and compare it to the text output of the new world and see what happened. I think I changed something which broke the entire world, or not broke it, but basically caused the algorithm to generate in a different way than it used to. So. For example, if you're playing Songbringer right now and you're in world A B C D E F and you're to play with this new code right here, it would be playing a different world. So it's not good. I need to fix this. I think this is what's going on. I'm not sure. I could be wrong. Hopefully I'm wrong. But I think I'm not. I think I actually changed something which in like the layout of the tower, which is a different dungeon. This is a crazy dungeon that's never been tried before with just tons of floors going straight up. I think something changed there that some random, it used up a couple random numbers beyond what it needed to or whatever, and then that changed everything else. So what I'll do for this week as I'm developing this tower dungeon and the tower dungeon boss and all that. I'll keep this window open the whole time, and I'll probably be frequently referring back to it just to make sure that the layout of all the dungeons is exactly the same. And if they're exactly the same, then I know the world's generating the same. Because even one single random number off will change the entire world. Okay, I think you're ready to go. Right, yeah, it's totally. I'm already fighting algorithms. Yeah, this looks more like the old world for sure. Remember there being the boss right down here. Think. Okay, let's see where it actually went wrong. Right away. Wait, no. I was like right away, but no. Okay, so dungeon one's fine. Yay, dungeon one is fine. Dungeon two. Where do we get the whammies? Where's the going wrong? That's what I'm wondering. That's exactly the same. Cool. Three. That's the same. Okay, this is looking good. I'm gonna check out latest. Get that recompiled. While I'm checking all this. Okay, so dungeon 3 is okay. Dungeon 4 also looks excellent. Nothing different. Okay, 5. It's good. 6. Six is the same. 7. This is really weird. Have you been showing the game at any cons? Yes, I have. I've been to some cons. Not like big ones, little ones. I've been to a thing called Indie Cup. Indie Cup's coming up again actually this year. This November. And then I've been to several of these like events here at Microsoft. What are they called? Playcrafting. I was at one just last three weeks ago. I was at an event showing Songbringer off. So yeah, I do those. But I can't afford to do the expensive ones. Like, for example, to go to GDC, to get the booth, just to have a booth at GDC is like $3,000 or something like that. And then, you know, having all the everything else, all your expenses, it's really expensive to go to the big cons. And, you know, it depends. How much results you get out of it, it all depends. I think I get better results out of just showing the game like I do every day. You know, I show it on Steam and all that. I mean, on this stream. I hope it ranks good on Steam as well. I think it'll do pretty well, but I don't like to create expectations. So this is the weird part right here. This dungeon is exactly the same as that dungeon, but I know for a fact that this dungeon does not look like this when I play it. And in fact, when I played this dungeon, it didn't even look like that. Unless I was in a different dungeon. Oh, I was in dungeon 9. Let's go back to 7. There's a Verloc, 2 to the left. Oh yeah, that's good. That's right. Oh, and then the boss is up straight up to the right. Oh yeah, okay. This is starting to feel familiar. I guess this is right. Okay. Nothing is broken. I was just thought it was broken, but it wasn't. This is good news. Because I have very much less work to do now. Yeah, dungeon 8's the same. 9, of course, is different because now it looks like a tower shape. Which means that 10 is probably different. Yeah, no rush, right? Yeah, exactly. It's all supposed to be this way. Everything is unfolding exactly as it should. I say that like a mantra. But I really mean it. Everything that's happened with Songbringer is all sort of like felt like it was meant to be that way. It's all turned out really well, and it feels just so right. Yeah, even this dungeon's the same. Okay, everything is fine. I was worried for nothing. Worried for nothing. The AI was fine, the algorithm was fine. Everything was good. Okay, well, How much time do I got left on today's stream? I think I can do one more little thing, maybe. I can do one more thing. Oh, I've only been streaming for an hour and 15. One more little thing. Okay. If a boss has been defeated in the tower, actually, if a boss has been defeated in general, let's go to this room, 119. It's going to still do the intro thing. Have you been to Burning Man? I was just at Burning Man last week, man. Yeah. Hell yeah, man. Burning Man is awesome. I love Burning Man. It's like a creative... It's like drinking creative... steroids. It's creative steroids. That's what it is. Okay. I just don't want it to do that boss fade-in thing. Which I think is going to happen in area to CPP. Why do you ask about Burning Man? Because I was mentioning it last week, or because you've been to Burning Man too? You missed it again? I definitely recommend going. I definitely recommend it. If it's your kind of thing, if you like going to festivals, you'll probably love Burning Man. It is quite an effort, though. It is quite an effort. I mean, you have to bring everything you need to survive in the desert, totally self-reliant style, for as long as you want to be there, for a week, you know? That's a lot of effort to be able to bring out just even a minor camp of your own. So it's a lot of effort, but it's a lot of payoff. It's a lot of reward for your effort as well. You know, it's not an easy thing to go to Burning Man, but it definitely rewards you for everything that you put into it. You know, it's like a whatever you put in, you get out type of thing. A top hat and a cactus. Oh, man, if only I owned a top hat and had some cactuses to eat out there. Jonah, you're describing my dream. This is my dream. Okay. If you remember from last year when I started watching your stream. Oh, because you're not from the U.S.? Oh, I see. Oh, man. I hear you. Yeah, all your friends were there? Damn. Oh. Well, it sounds like your friends know where it's at. The party, that is. It's the biggest party I know of. Next time, man. If you're going next time, you gotta remember me. Hit me up. See if I'm gonna be there that year. We'll get together, do something crazy. Where's that little bit of, man, here it is. Set ambience, yeah. Okay, so this is where it pauses the music and does this whole fade-in thing. But we don't want to do this if the boss has already been defeated. So we'll get the boss status. So, or boss status. Okay, boss defeated. Hopefully that's everything that's needed. All right, Pedro. Good night, man. Have a good one. Thanks for stopping by. Yay, it worked. If the boss has already been defeated, it doesn't do the boss intro. Yay! I gotta check him out real quick. So if I take this off, the boss is no longer defeated. It should do the intro now. See that coming in from the other room now. Now, if the boss is defeated, cool. No intro, no fade in. Right? There's no sound effect. There's no music though. Well, that's because it's a boss room. Well, good. Okay, that's one more thing off the list. That was a quick two-liner. Okay, so don't do boss roar if boss already defeated. Okay, I still got time for a few more things today. Thank you very much. I'm gonna do a few things. So, mathematically, from a code perspective and all that, if you have the boss defeated flag for the tower, the last level, that indicates that you've completed all the bosses up to the last boss, but not the final boss. So this basically kills... Putting that as a 1 will kill all the bosses in the tower, but not outside the tower in the top. And then putting that at 0 means you have to fight through every single boss. So I'm going to put it back to 0 really quick and do a few things to make it. So first of all, it can have multiple bosses in the same Z. And then what? Oh, and then also make it so it's not going to mark... the bosses defeated until you get to the very last one. But there's one more thing. There's always one more thing. Story of my life. Especially when I look at my Trello list, there's always one more thing. I don't even want to look at it right now. The Trello list is too long. Right? I had it down to like only 10 more items on my now list, and now there's like 110 items. It just grows. It just grows and grows and grows and grows. I'm like, oh, I gotta do that, gotta do that, gotta do that. Let me list this so I don't forget it. Now the list is like 110 things long. Because I'm still creating things. I'm still in the creative phase. I'm like creating the last dungeon here. So after that, I'll start getting into the phase where I can really refine things because there won't be as much new stuff creating feature creep. Okay, so if that's, I want that at zero. Want to make it first of all so that there can be multiple bosses on the last dungeon, which is going to be in world add foes. Backlog. Yes, the backlog is too long. It's so long. But I can't let it weigh on me. I gotta still be in the creative zone, you know? Yeah, I use Git all the time. I've always used Git. Yeah, but I did start using Trello. Trello is a great thing. I'm glad to be using Trello instead of. You probably saw I used to use like a friggin' text file. I was like, here's all the things I gotta do. They're all in this text file list. Trello is way better than that, I'll tell you. All right, so it tracks what kind of foes it's placed already. Yeah, you remember. You totally remember, Gladiar. Ah, right? Yeah. Yep. Yeah. It's funny, funny shit. Foe kinds. Right, didn't I? It was kind of faster to type, but it wasn't exactly faster when you wanted to find a certain item and mark one as completed and all that stuff. Ah, man, I'm a pretty opinionated person, so funny. I'm like, no, it's faster this way. Yeah, you suggested it. Thank you for that suggestion. Your suggestion did make its way somewhere into my brain at that point. And then eventually, enough people said you should use Trello that I tried it. I've never looked back. Here it is. Okay, so this is a little bit that prevents it from using two, doing two of the same kind of foe in one Z. So this is the same Z. Every level of the tower is technically the same Z. So. We need to not. Oh, this is part of it too. Foe kinds. So the last level of the tower, that's not quite the last level. Well, basically we can allow bosses to repeat. On the last level Z. Let me just see how that affects everything. By turning on world verbosity, I think four that will show all of the enemies that it's placing and the bosses and all that. No, it's five. World velocity five. There we go. All right, so going to the boss for 9. One one nine as Fokine boss 2. And what did the one right before it have? Oh, I guess it wouldn't have mattered because this would have boss 1. But once we go to Z, right here they are, zeros, these. Yeah, these are the extra Z's. Okay, 180. 1-1, it's supposed to be 1-1, 180. Oh no, it starts with 185. What? None of these have bosses? Oh, probably because we've already used the Z. Okay. We've already used it for this Z. So if I turn this on, it's not going to change anything yet. But it will fix some other worlds. Other worlds will need that. Right, so it didn't put any foes. Oh, wait, it did. Oh, but then it can't repeat. That's fine. So put boss 2 there. Oh, and it gave it one more choice. So it did change the world. It did change a little bit because this has boss 1 when... Eight also had boss 1. The map generator. Yeah, the map generator is even more dope now. Check it out. It can, like, it shows a bunch of different seeds, so I can look at a lot of different world seeds really quickly. So it just, like, flips between levels. There's wizard, butter, rupees. It just goes and shows them all so I can see. I especially am focusing on the number down there at the bottom where it says 0 retries. 0 retries is awesome. That means that it generated that entire world without having to try again. There's nothing that failed. And if I make my algorithms really, really good, then there will be 0 retries. But you can see there's still some levels with 1 retry, 2 retries. Yeah. But this is just showing the overworld. There's dungeons too. So I should probably throw dungeons into this somehow as well. So you could see everything kind of at a glance. That not only the overworld, but the dungeons too. That'd be good. But yeah, this is very helpful. This is an incredibly helpful tool to be able to see a whole world like this. You know, or at least the overworld, and see what it looks like at a glance, but also see the details and statistics of it and stuff like that. I'm glad I wrote that. It's been very helpful. Yeah, sexual, nipple. What are the other ones? I don't know. Zilton. It's all Zilton stuff. Zilton's like, nipple. Actually, it might not have been Zilton, but Zilton can have the credit. Okay, so we're matching Max. Is Arcane still a bug fest? It's not. Yeah, it's not. Arcane, your world is kicking ass, I'm pretty sure. Let's check. Let's check that. Pretty sure Arcane has zero retries and there hasn't been a single bug in it in a while. Playthrough time! Playthrough time! Yeah, look, zero retries. This is the world, Arcane. Don't look for too long. You're gonna get all the secrets ruined. All right, I was just gonna make it so it doesn't even match the max. For the last level. Playthrough time! I've actually been kind of saving up the playthrough for when the game is totally finished. This is the last dungeon! This is the last dungeon! The tower! Once this dungeon is complete, it's going to be playthrough time. I'll do a playthrough. I promise. I promise to do a playthrough as soon as the game is all complete like this. And it will be in about a week, maybe 2 weeks max. But definitely soon. The game is going to be content complete. Okay, yeah, we have a boss. Let's check it out. Make sure that it did put a boss on every one of the floors of this dungeon. Yay! Hooray! Yeah, I know. You've been wanting a playthrough for a while. I've been wanting to do a playthrough too, but I've just been kind of saving it. Saving for when it's all done and content complete. There's going to be a lot of polish left to do. Lots of polish, but at least it'll be somewhat content complete. A lot less feature creep after the next 2 weeks are said and done. A state machine? What you mean? For all those if statements? Oh, what, for this bit of code here? Okay. Help me understand how this could be better. I'm not sure exactly how a state machine could make this better. Tell me, my friend. Tell me what could be better here. I'm trying to open my mind. I'm prying my mind open. I'm prying my third eye open. So 0 through 4, these are all tunnels. But 185. Okay, we got boss number 2. 185. What? And then I guess that boss number 1 was on the first floor. So this is boss 1, boss 2, boss 2, boss 2. It worked. It put bosses on every floor. Let's see if it worked, like, actually in practice. Time to restart the project. Start over. Damn it. Those too many if statements right there. Start writing all 70,000 lines of Songbringer over again. Okay, so this is floor 1. This is the very first floor, right? Yeah, 119. First floor. Just gonna kill this boss by cheating. Use the elevator now, go up the next level. Should be a boss on this next floor. Yay, there's a boss. Okay, we'll kill this boss too by cheating. This is gonna be quite a hard dungeon. There's four bosses you have to fight. Mini, are these gonna be like mini bosses? I'm imagining they're not your typical bosses in a party. I forgot about this guy. This has this one little issue. Oh, what? That works.
works.
Okay, floor number three, right? Yeah, 186. It's technically the third floor of this dungeon. Cool, we have another boss. These technically don't have to be in the same order. Right? But yeah, but how could I write that as a state machine and make it look cleaner? I'm all about cleaner code. Boss. Next floor. I think this is the last floor. Is it? Is this outside? No, this is the last. Okay, there's four bosses. And then the final boss. Right? This will be hard as hell. And you have to beat all four bosses. Possibly without saving. I'm writing the code so you can do it either way. You can save at the very top or not save. So it'll be kind of like a some kind of question I'll ask you guys at some point. Should you be able to save after fighting all four of these bosses should you be able to save right before the final boss? That's the question. Or should you have to fight all five bosses every time? So this should be the last floor. No, what? There's another floor? There's too many floors. I might have to get rid of one of these floors. Jonah's like, yes! Make me fight all the bosses. Wait, are you saying yes, there should be a save point? Or no, there should not be a save point? Get him, Bell. Cheating is so easy. You know what? This is a really good question. Should you be forced to save? Should you have the ability to save? Okay, here's the last level. Okay, so there was like five levels, and then this is the sixth level, I think. Fight the final boss, which of course will not look like this. You're not gonna fight the blob boss over and over. But this is gonna be a cool area right here where you're on the top of the tower. There shouldn't be any wall up here in this. This looks weird. It should just be the top of a tower here. Okay, I don't have very much courage. Not the kind of situation I should have, but I'm gonna try this. I'm gonna try and fight my way through this entire dungeon right now. Here goes nothing! So we need more courage for sure. We need the glove. Oh, you're saying yes, there should be a save point before the final boss. I tend to agree with you there. But I know Boogie's gonna say no. Pedro will probably say no. I don't know. It'll all depend on what feels right in the end. It'll kind of depend on how difficult the four bosses are before it, you know. Okay, so I got a ghost sword. I need some proper weapons here. Let's say I have the lightning sword. Chip. I need the chip and the boots and the glove. Okay, I think I'm set now. And also, I need some super bombs. Ravro's like, no, make it like Dark Souls, no save point! Oh, thanks, Ladiar. I'll read up on that. I'll read that article and see if there's something I can learn, grow a little bit as a programmer, and maybe write that in a better way. Thank you, man. Okay, are we ready to do this? Oh, we need super bombs as well. Super bombs. Where are they at? Well, we need super bomb containers. Let's do Let's see, I found one of them. And I have three of those. Let's see, I have ice bombs. And fire top hat. No, wait, I already got the fire blink. Let's see the poison top hat. Okay, now I'm pretty much set. I have a ton of weapons. 48 bombs. Oh, I need a flask too. Gotta make sure I have a flask for this fight, because I need to at least be able to refill health once through fighting all these bosses. What's the flask? Oh, here we go. Flask. Okay, I have one full flask. All right, I think we're ready to do this. We'll start the player all the way at the bottom. All right, I'm attempting to fight six bosses in a row. No, oh yeah, no, you can't craft the super bomb. There's already five things you can craft. That's a good question. Actually, it wouldn't be that hard to add the super bomb, make it craftable. And then you would have a choice, so you wouldn't be able to craft everything in every world. Interesting choice. Maybe. I'm gonna say maybe at this point. So far, it hasn't been designed that way, where you can craft the super bomb, but I don't see why not. Okay, got items. What do I got? Okay. Alright, I think these items are good. Oh, another one? I will check this out too. Okay, here we go. Six bosses in a row. Is it possible? Yeah, I guess it would be if there was an enemy. Because I already marked him as the... Oh, I gotta mark this guy as... Okay, there's one thing left to do before I can do this. I have to make it so it's not gonna mark a boss as defeated. It is always good to give players more choices, right? Yes! I'm all about this. All about more choices. More choices, less railroading. Less containment. Less forced experience. Okay, so where it marks bosses as defeated, I don't want it to do that. I guess it's in probably collision system. Flag this boss as defeated. Here we go. If areas flag boss. And level Z is not equal to K world num levels. Okay, so that's going to make it so it never ever saves the bosses. Not in the world of UX. Good point. Good point. And also not in the world of sales. Online sales, the more choices you give people, the less sales you get. You want to craft the boots with fire? That would be kind of cool, actually. Right? You would, bug mashing. That would be the only thing you could craft them with. Maybe lightning too. Lightning or fire, either one of those. And you want the... Why did he only drop two hearts? Or two teeth? Okay, that wasn't that hard. And it did save. Okay, I want to check if it... Good, it did not change the boss status. Okay, I'm trying to fight... fight this boss a little more intelligently this time and not just get hurt. Yes! Boss number two, gotcha! This guy dropped a lot. Whoa, thank you for dropping so much stuff. Why did the last guy not drop anything? This guy's like, hey, this is gonna get you fully powered up. So that's one thing. Since the bosses drop all this health and stuff, it's almost like you're not really having to fight five bosses in a row with all the items you have. You kind of have some leeway there with the bosses dropping. So that's one thing that can be tweaked, tuned a little bit. Like, should the bosses drop items? How much items should they drop? Bell's done. Look up, Bell, we got a big drop boss to fight. Okay, so keep in mind, all these bosses are gonna be different. You're not even gonna fight this guy. It's gonna be a different boss. Bosses all the way up this dungeon. And then the final boss, of course, is going to be totally different. I'm just testing it out to see what it's like to fight five bosses in a row right here. This is going to be a little test. Crazy idea. Crafting the chip with elements disables the ghost sword effect. Make your swing extra strong. With elemental effects? Interesting! Interesting, Jonah. Let me add these to the Trello list. I think you already have your own Trello item. But this is, I gotta record. This is great thinking. I wanna put this on the Trello list so I can remember to come back to this at some point, because this is a really great idea. Ideas in general. I think you have some ideas here. Cool. So now I know to come back to this at some point and do something about it. Or not. No, right? Yes, I need to take some kind of action in regards to that, because it's a great idea. Even if it's simple, right? If I can find a very simple way, you know, not, because the thing that's really hard, the action is forget it. The thing that's really hard is to develop a whole item that has like five different sub items. Like for example, the top hat having five different things is really hard. But you bring up a really simple idea in that you just craft it with one little thing. So there's like one more glove or whatever. It's just like a hyper glove or whatever. It's totally doable. It's a lot more doable than creating five more items. This is pretty interesting, finding all these bosses in such a tiny room. All the other boss fights in the game so far have been in big rooms. Gotcha! Okay, this is totally doable. With having it refill your health every time by the bosses dropping tons of items makes it kinda easy, actually. And if all of these bosses were different and interesting and stuff, and if there was stuff going on each level, like maybe this is a secret area, or maybe there's an item here, some important item, or something interesting on each level of the tower besides just the boss. Maybe there's a puzzle here in this room or something. Mm-hmm. multiple bosses at once? That would be cool. I guess that there are several bosses where they have little minions, but there aren't any bosses yet where there's multiple of the same, like, big boss. Do you have towers as well? This is the only tower dungeon. Yeah, there's not any yet, but that's a really great idea. That would be cool actually for the towers, fighting multiple bosses at once. That would add a really cool dynamic, especially in such tiny rooms. Yeah, this is the tower. This is the last level of the tower. Okay, so this is the final boss. Once again, it's the same exact boss, but keep in mind this boss fight, this very last boss fight is gonna be very interesting. There's a guy in mind. I have something planned for this. I've already drawn him, sketched him up, got his ideas for his attacks, and stuff like that. This should be a pretty rad fight here. So okay, that was totally doable. I just did a little test through all fighting all those bosses in a row, and it's doable. It's totally doable, especially if the bosses drop health. So I'm thinking either the bosses shouldn't drop any health on the way up. Yeah, in fact, I think I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna make it so all bosses definitely do not drop any health. And then maybe in some of the corners, the extra rooms on the tower, you might find health there. To recharge a little bit on your way up, just to make it more of a challenge, because that was too easy. I don't even really lose health on that. Yes, yeah, this is the tower from the opening cutscene, from the poster, this tower thing. Yep. Alright. Okay, cool. I think that's it for today's stream. That was a good stream. Kind of got the structure of this tower created. Have I played... You mean Diablo 2? Are you talking about Diablo 2 or what? Tristram, this sounds familiar. Yeah, you're talking about Diablo 2. Which one was Tristram? I forget this guy. I played that shit out of Diablo 2. I love Diablo 2. I think I like Diablo 2. I haven't played Diablo 3. I love Diablo 2 and 1 so much. I played this game too much. Oh, Tristram's a place. Oh. Okay, I forgot what Tristram was. Okay. Cool. Alright, y'all. You have quite a few health hearts when you reach this tower. Yeah, you'll have lots of health at this point. Saving the game after each boss. Oh, you can lose a heart? Interesting. That would be an interesting trade-off. Oh, Uber... Okay, wait. I didn't know anything... I've never done that before. I didn't know there was an Uber Tristram. Really? Is this like the cow level? What? I never knew this was here. Oh, sweet. And they have all these Uber bosses? Or Uber monsters? Whoa. What? I never knew this was here. What? Let me mute this just in case it's got copyrighted audio in it. Yeah, this is so crazy. I played Diablo 2 so much. I never knew this was here. Whoa. Okay, so all the bosses are just like. I forgot how much I love this game. Makes me want to crack out Diablo 2 and play it tonight, man. Oh, it did? My screen froze? Oh, it might have been this. I was in full screen. La 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 la. Yeah, I think it was that. Full screen mode, YouTube probably didn't work. Yeah, Hell Unleashed mode? Is that like just beyond difficult? I forgot about all these, the skill trees and everything. Why does this feel like it looks different to me? I don't know. Oh, it's a mod? Oh, okay, it's a mod. I forgot, man, I forgot how dope this game was for its for 1998? Is that when Diablo 2 came out? No. 2000? When the hell was this? 2000, June 29th. I probably bought it on the day it came out. Such epic. Gladiar, what do you think about Diablo 3, man? Have you played Diablo 3? I haven't played Diablo 3. I've heard it's not as good, but I don't know. Maybe I was just... You were raised... I was too. I was raised on this and StarCraft. Those are my two favorite games growing up. Besides Nintendo and Super Nintendo and all that. Yeah, yeah, right? It was only 16 years ago. It sucks. Yeah. Some people hate it. Some people love it. Huh. I guess I should give it a try then. Wow, this makes me want to play this, this Uber Tristram. I didn't even know about this. So cool. You're level 97? Whoa. Whoa. Wow, cool. I love Easter eggs. I want to put some cool Easter eggs in Songbringer for sure. So yeah, it was good chatting with you guys today. Yesterday I tried to do a stream and the chat didn't work and my voice didn't work. Today I streamed the same exact settings, nothing changed, and everything worked today. So I don't know. D3 does have the Exocet font. So yeah, it was good chatting with you guys today. That's it for today's stream. I'll probably stream tomorrow. If not that, definitely Monday. And I'll just be working on the tower, the last level of Songbringer here all week. Bosses, gonna be working on bosses a lot this week. Mini bosses or something to go along the way, and then the final boss too. Yeah, it's good to see you guys too. See you, everybody. Yeah. Laters. Laters.